Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video tutorial, I will show you how to format the appearance of SyncFusion React pivot table cells with user-defined styles based on conditions. I will also show you how to change the background color, font family, and font size based on specific conditions. Let me open my existing example, where I've installed the SyncFusion React pivot view package. I have also bound JSON data using the data source property. Let's take a look at the data bound to the data source. It contains fields like sold, amount, country, product, etc., are mapped to the row, column, and value axes. You can refer to my getting started video shared in the card above or in the description below to learn more about local data binding. I'll run this application. See, the pivot table rendered based on a JSON object. To enable conditional formatting, import its module from the SyncFusion EJ2 React Pivot View package and inject it into the pivot services. Then include the allow conditional formatting property in the pivot table and set its value to true. Then to display the conditional formatting icon, I need to enable the toolbar. I import the toolbar module from EJ2 React Pivot View package and inject it to the pivot services. I set the show toolbar property to true. Next, I include the toolbar property and set the conditional formatting option. Check, the conditional formatting icon is displayed at the top left corner of the toolbar. Click that, and the conditional formatting dialog will open. Since no format is applied in the pivot report, you will see the text, "No format found." Click the Add Condition button, and you will see the drop-down containing fields mapped to the value axis, like units sold and sold amount. I choose the field, units sold. In the next drop-down, I need to choose an operator type from less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, equals, not equals, between and not between. When you choose operators like between and not between, you need to provide two values. Here, I choose the less than option. I need to provide the value to apply the condition. I set the value to 500. I can also change the cell format. Choose the font family as Times New Roman. Change the size to 14 pixels. Choose the font color and background color. Here, you can preview the cell formatting. Click the Apply button. Check the pivot table, data is formatted based on the condition specified. To remove the conditional formatting, open the dialog again and click the Delete icon, click the Apply button. Check now, the format is removed. Next, I will show you how to apply conditional formatting in code behind. Include the conditional format settings property and using measure property to specify the name of the value axis field to be formatted. Then, assign the field amount. Note that you should assign the data source field name and not the caption. Then I specify the operator's name using the conditions property. Use the between operator. Since this operator requires two values, I specify the values using value 1 and value 2 properties. Set 1 lakh to value 1 and 8 lakh to value 2. In the style option, I specify the background color as mixed green, font color as black, font family as Tahoma, and font size as 12 pixels to be applied in pivot report. Check now, the cells in the sold amount field are formatted based on the condition specified. To apply formatting to all the fields, I need to omit the measure property while specifying the condition. Set the operator to less than and value 1 property to 4 locks. Copy pastes the styles from this condition and change the background color as cyan. Check now all the fields in the value axis are formatted based on the condition specified. Finally, I will show you how to open the conditional formatting dialog using external button click. I have already installed the EJ2 React Buttons package in this example to use SyncFusion buttons. Import the button component from the EJ2 React Buttons package. Let me include the button component, and to the render the primary button, use the CSS class property and assign a value, e-primary. I provide the text as apply format. Then I include the onClick event and assign the callback method, apply format. Inside this method, I call the built-in method showConditionalFormatting dialog from pivotView component. Declare variable pivot object and provide the module name as pivotView. Then I include ref property and assign the object. At last, call the showConditionalFormatting dialog method from conditionalFormatting module. In the index.css page, apply margin style to the button. Check now, when I click this button, the conditional formatting dialog opens. In this video, you've learned how to format the appearance of SyncFusion React pivot table cells with user-defined styles based on conditions. I also showed you how to change the background color, font family, and font size based on specific conditions. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. I've also included a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use all our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.